It's absolutely true. You are going to be in a box like one of them, and you have not got an answer.
That's why I'm here.
Not an answer? I'd like to hear it. Now look, I meet people who tell me they're atheists. Let me show you the stupidity of being an atheist. How you want it? What's it? In the national newspaper called the Daily Mail, you might read it. Jamie Bulger was good. You're a model breed, aren't you? And you know, if I steal your car, it's wrong. And I know if I smash your face in, or you smash my delightful face in, it's wrong. And you know, if somebody runs off with your missus, you get angry. Well, why do you get angry? Because you know it's wrong, you shall not commit adultery. Ladies and gentlemen, why is there a crematorium up the road at Southport at the top? Why is there a graveyard in Birkdale? I'll tell you, because people die. Unless they put them in prematurely, which is a major problem. But ladies and gentlemen, have you got an answer? You haven't. The atheist has got to hope for the best. And his best hope is, I hope there's nothing next. But that flies in the face of Jesus Christ, who said these words: it's appointed unto man once to die. Just once, you don't get two runs at life. Once, and after this, a judgment. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if God judged my life, he'd find me guilty. I've done wrong. Can I lovingly say this? When he looks at your life, you know he finds you guilty, because you find you guilty too. So you don't even need his witness that you've got it wrong. I'll tell you some great news. You can be let off. Jesus came into the world to die. That's why he was born. Call his name Jesus. He will save his people from their sin. Sin he's saving from. Jesus died on a cross to let you off. Can you see why he was there? He hung on the cross, ladies and gentlemen, out of love for you and me, to obliterate, wipe out everything you've ever done wrong so you can enter heaven pure. Will you do it? Will you enter heaven pure? I have done wrong, ladies and gentlemen. You can ask any of my six sisters, they'll soon shoot me. But I know I'm forgiven. Are you forgiven? Jesus is a fact. He lived, he died. He died on the cross, and he can let the worst of us off. Ladies and gentlemen, no matter how bad you've been, the blood of Jesus, God's Son, can wash you white as the snow. And the risen Jesus can be your friend. That's why I'm here. You see these guys? They're only you with a few years left put on, aren't they? It's still you and me with a few years put on. And it's our turn to leave the planet. Will you leave forgiven or not? Now I'm going to finish there. Finish by name. You can ask a question if you wish. I've got a gospel there called the Gospel of John. In that book, this is what it says: I've come that you may have life, and life in all of its fullness. I'm giving that to anybody who'll take it from my hand and read it. I've come that you may have life, and life in all of its fullness. That's what we need, folks. We need hope beyond the grave, and I've got it, and that's why I'm here sharing it. I don't give two hoots what you think about me. They sometimes think I'm a crackpot. This world needs more crackpots. Like me, let's bring them on. But here's a little Gospel of John. Would you like me? God bless you. Have a lovely afternoon in Southport. Thank you. Just come and take this from my hand, anybody who'd like one. Thank you, sir.